Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland with another knife video, and this one here is going to be a video in the knife series of borrowed blades. This is a series where I show you loaned in knives from fellow knife collectors here in Europe, and this gives me the opportunity to show you things that I otherwise wouldn't be able to handle. And this thing here is a very, very special knife, and a knife that I actually looked at a couple of times to consider buying off the secondary market, because on their primary launch these were very hard to get. You only could get them through a Lotto on the Recon One's website, and you can see it certainly is a Shirogorov, but not just any Shirogorov. This is actually a Shirogorov and Dmitry Sinkevich collaboration Kami. So this is one of the newest collaboration of Shirogorov knives with Dmitry Sinkevich. I believe they have done numerous collaborations in the past. Both are of course very famous Russian brands or knife makers. And this one here is an absolutely great collaboration. Very interesting designs, lots of interesting features, and a great size. If you know Shirogorov and their higher-end models, you know that most of their higher-end stuff is usually pretty large. They have a lot of large different models. That's their primary kind of standard model that they have, which is the F95, which is pretty large, especially if you look at my collection. I usually carry medium to small size knives. And so it's really cool to see that Shirogorov is doing a higher end kind of collaboration piece in a very good pocket friendly size. Just to get it out of the way, let's take a look at what we're getting in the box. So first off, of course, you are getting your certificate of authenticity here. You can see the Shirogorov bear and the Dmitry Sinkevich logo there and collaboration. And on the back side, you see we have the Kami flipper. The steel is S110V. And this one is model 89 of 300, and you have the signature of both makers. And it, of course, is running on multi-row bearing system, which is the higher-end bearing system that Shirogorov is using. Other than that, you're just getting a cardboard box, so nothing really special there on the packaging. Shirogorov is not very noted for doing great presentation and great intense packaging. But that's just how it is. Of course, on a knife that costs as much as this, I believe these one were new from Recon One, $1,500, so not an inexpensive knife by any stretch of the imagination. And to get a knife like that in such a pretty toned down cardboard box is just a bit of a bummer, but the knife itself certainly makes up for a lot of it. And this one is a thing that I think you don't actually get with the knife itself. So Shirogorov is actually selling the tool or the bits for these Sinkevich collaborations in a kind of a pen format that has the bit in the back, and you can use the back of the pen as your screwdriver. I believe this one is bought aftermarket or maybe even made by the loaner of this knife, which is Guillaume Opsomer, a great fellow collector from Belgium. And he just put it into the box if I wanted to take it apart, but I don't think that these actually come with the knife, which once again is another little thing that I would love to see on such an expensive high-end knife, that you would get the tool with the knife itself, because I think these pens that you can buy from Shirogorov with the tools are also quite expensive. So that adds just some more cost to this already expensive knife. And then you're getting your standard Shirogorov microfiber cloth with the bear on there, which is cool, but certainly nothing very, very special. You get that with any kind of Shirogorov knife that you might buy. So let's take a look at the knife itself. This is the Shirogorov Kami. You know, this is limited to 300 pieces. This is a model 89, and let's deploy it. So this is an absolutely great looking knife. You have a 3.5-inch blade, and I'm just forgetting the overall length, but on these borrowed blades videos, I normally don't do specs, but you will see quite a bit of comparison knives later in the video, so you can get a good feel for the size of the Kami. But overall, to say the size is great for my hand size. You know, I have a 7.5 sterile glove, and it fits my hand absolutely perfectly. You also can notice that we have a complex asymmetrical grind. So here we have like an additional bevel right there before we get to the edge bevel. And here we have a gorgeous mirror polished edge. And here we have just a regular kind of flat ground edge. We've got a gorgeous Swatch at the top, and we got a nice two-tone blade. So we got a hand rub satin finish on the flats, and then this media blasted finish that you see on a lot of different Shirogorov knives. Then we got a very intensely milled and greatly designed handle scale. Reminds me a bit of a topographic pattern here. So we've got lots of different layers, four different layers of titanium, very cleanly milled. This is certainly a strong suit of Shirogorov, milling absolutely perfect scales and working with titanium. We got a decorative pivot screw here on the show side. We see we have like also this media blasted middle part, and then on the edges we have some nice polished edges that really play with the lights very well and contrast really good with the more shiny and reflective hand drop satin finish. And then you can see, other than that, there is no real visible hardware. We come to that a little bit later in the video. If you flip it over, we see we have a frame lock with an external lock bar cutout, which is a bit of a miss, especially at the price point. And when you have such gorgeous milling on the handle, I would love to see the internal cutout here on this build here. That would certainly dress it up a bit, and I think it could be done quite easily. So that's a bit of a miss to have this large kind of lock bar cutout, also because it kind of interferes with your pocket clip. There you see it halfway lands in that divot of the lock bar cutout. Then here we have the proprietary tool that you have seen before that would work with this kind of triway thing. It's not the same triway that you see, for example, on a Microtech, so it's the special kind of Sinkovich hardware. Same finish on the pivot. We also got it nicely blue anodized, looks really sleek. We got a stainless steel lock bar insert that works as an over travel and also is screwed in from the inside, so you just see the end of that screw there. Then we got a very ingenious clip and backspacer design, which is one of the special features you're getting here on the Kami, and that is that the 3D milled titanium deep carry pocket clip, as well as the backspacer or standoff and the lanyard hole, is actually one piece of titanium that is screwed in from the back with these two blue anodized screws. So that's why you don't see any kind of other hardware on the presentations or the show side. That makes for a very clean overall design and look. And here you can see how this works. It also means that this tip up carry clip is actually left and right side reversible. You just have to unscrew it, flip it around, and then you will have the clip here on your show side. So pretty ingenious thing here to do a backspacer and a clip like this. Also means that the clip works actually very, very well, and it's a quite deep carry clip on such a high-end knife, which I certainly like to see. And the design on the clip is also very nicely done, suits in very well with the overall milling on that handle, and just a cool thing how they actually executed the backspacer thing here. In terms of the lanyard hole, which never is a big thing for me personally, but when you use that lanyard hole, you cannot use too thick of a fabric, because you can see, if you look through the lanyard hole, you can certainly see the tip of that blade. So if you use really thick stuff, you could actually slice that on the tip of that blade, because they really used every last little micro inch here to squeeze quite a large knife in a very, very manageable overall handle. Other than that, we have some massive, massive internal milling here on this blade. You can see here, very nice honeycomb skeletonization. This is a very lightweight folder for its size. Lots of internal milling all around. We also got markings on the inside here. It's a Sinkovich design. On the other side, you have your Shirogorov bear logo. And there are lots of little hidden markings on this knife all around. For example, the S110V is marked here on the spine of the blade. If you only open it kind of halfway, which is hard because the action is so well done. We can also see here we have engraved 89 of 300. So you know it's just the right one that fits also the certificate. And on the other side, we're actually getting the MRBS logo. So this runs on multi-row bearing systems, which are loose bearings in a bearing race, in a like Mickey Mouse and Lollipop kind of pattern. You will see an inlaid picture there. And overall, just a very, very good looking knife in the close position. as well as in the fully open state. So I really like the overall design. You can certainly see the influence of Dmitry Sinkevich here in this design. One thing that I'm not a big fan of in the closed position is that you actually can see the cutout right there. So you can see my finger through there. There is this little kind of gap, which I think could have been done better, should have been done better actually, for a $1,500 knife made from S110V and titanium. This is pretty much a very, very sore spot for the eyes, in my opinion, that you have this kind of gap right there. Just seems like it wasn't really attended to when designing the knife and looks a bit odd on an otherwise such greatly designed overall piece. Also, some little details that are nice here. You can see the chamfers on the flipper tab. You also can see the special grind here with like the double plunge. Really good looking. This thing is extremely, extremely sharp, and the action is certainly the star of the show here on that Kami. That is certainly to be expected for a high-end Shirogorov knife. Shirogorov is really a company that has absolutely perfected a flipper action on bearings and is very synonymous with great action in the knife community, and that is certainly a deserved title that Shirogorov holds. You can see there is absolutely no kind of friction on this folder, super easy to deploy, but you have a very strong and defined detent, no kind of detent lash or anything. You have a very minimalist flipper tab that works really well. Some good jimping, long run of jimping right there. You can just use it as a light switch or a push button. One thing you have to be very careful when using this knife is not to put any kind of pressure on this lock bar. It's very sensitive to lock bar pressure. I have gotten the hang of it now since I have this for a couple of days, so it works pretty much every time. But if you put any kind of pressure on that lock bar, you cannot really deploy it. And if you slip off this pretty aggressive jimping, that can hurt quite a bit. And that is just something you have to keep in mind when you have a Kami flipper. The finish on the handle is like a standard kind of bead blasting that you see, or media blasting that you see on a lot of Shirogorov knives. And one thing I really like about the blade design is how they executed this area right here. So it swoops up a little bit, the spine of the blade then goes down, everything is nicely jimped, you got this larger jim just at the end, and this just cradles your thumb absolutely perfectly. Super, super comfortable overall folder. Now let's do some size comparison. So first, we have the Shirogorov sandwich that we do here on the channel. So we have the F95NL at the top, which is going to be quite a bit larger. And then my favorite production Shirogorov model, which is the Neon Zero right here. And you can see it's pretty much the same size as the Shirogorov Neon Zero. That also does a great thing with the backspacer. You have this hollowed out kind of backspacer that houses a very nicely and large blade in a very compact handle, which is something I really like on these Shirogorov knives. Here we also have the external lock bar cut out, unfortunately. But other than that, a very, very nicely done blade here on the Neon Zero. Of course, it's not S110V on this one. I believe it's M390. But here you can get a good feel for the overall size of the Kami. It's very close to a Neon Zero in pretty much any dimension. Also, great backspacer right there. And then we have our standard kind of EDC blades to show you. Para 3 is going to be shorter, and Benchmade Bug Out, full size Bug Out, which is also going to be shorter. So overall, a great size in my opinion for EDC if you're actually going to use a knife like this with the price attached to it, and then some customs to compare it to. And you have to keep in mind that the customs here are both less expensive than this Shirogorov and Dmitry Sinkevich collaboration Kami. Here we have the JK Knives Dwarf. Also some great milling on that titanium handle, a little bit shorter, and this is quite a bit heavier because here we have really intense internal milling all the way around that really lightens this knife up quite a lot. And then we have the Skiff Drifter. Absolutely gorgeous piece. Also some great, great milling. And you can see size-wise, it's also a little bit larger than the Skiff Drifter, as you can see right here. So overall, absolutely cool design by Dmitry Sinkevich and Shirogorov. And certainly a good looking knife with a lot of special things like the asymmetrical grind, which I actually could go without. I think this is more of a gimmick than anything you notice in use or that adds a lot of things to the knife itself. I would go with a regular grind on this knife. It wouldn't detract from anything, in my opinion. I like the design on that clip and backspacer construction. I love the overall size. The action is great, but I think it shouldn't be that sensitive to lock bar pressure, especially at the price point. And I would love to see, or I expect to see, an internal lock bar cutout. And I don't want to have this gap here just at the pivot area. Other than that, this is an absolutely insanely nice flipper and certainly would be an absolute grail for any kind of Shirogorov collector, especially since they are limited to 300 pieces. But if you look at it from a numbers game, I think $1,500 for a knife like this that is actually quite similar to the Neon Zero here, for example, is certainly asking a bit much. I think the limited edition nature really comes in there to drive up the price a bit. Of course, a Sinkevich collaboration is also going to add to the price. It's an absolutely well-made knife, great design, has some cool features, but I can't see being it that much more expensive than something like this. And if I look at the customs I have in the collection, that are quite a bit less expensive, and what I can get there in the custom realm, I think it's getting harder and harder to actually justify spending that much for a more or less machine-made product from an absolutely high-end manufacturer. But still, it's certainly not a custom knife. That is something everybody has to decide for themselves what they value more, but this is certainly very well made, absolutely gorgeous design with an insane action, and I'm very happy that I actually could check out this Shirogorov Kami. And thanks again to Guillaume Opsomer for making this possible. I hope you could get some good information here on this knife, and thank you for watching. Don't forget to check out White Mountain Knives and use my discount code 7Ready to get 10% off your entire order from anything you get on that website. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram at 7Ready_knife_reviews. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.